Hello, I have set up my Nikon Z6, and how I set it up, I would like to share with you guys. It doesn't mean it's the best way. It's just my way for my use case, the way I like it, and this might change. So let's run through the settings. Playback menu, I leave pretty much as it is. Photoshoot menu. Reset Photoshoot menu basically does what it says. It resets the entire Photoshoot menu. Storage folder. Standard you have NCZ6. You can change a folder number. Let's say, let's put this. When you go in, you have a new folder. So you can set it to this folder. So now you have on the Z6 this folder. File name. File name standard is DSC, but for my Nikon D750 and 850, I have D750 and D850. But you can leave it as it is. Choose image area. It's an FX body full frame. So I want the maximum size, resolution, etc. So I left it at FX. So FX. Image quality. You can shoot JPEGs or TIFF, multiple sizes, etc. Or you can shoot both RAW and JPEG. But I want RAW. I shoot RAW. Image size. If you shoot JPEG, you can set different image sizes to large, medium, or small. Well, if I shoot JPEG, I want them big. Same goes for RAW. Big. But you can change them to small, medium, but I want large. NEF recording. Do I want compression? No, this is compressed. It saves about a half of your file size, as I understand. Lossless compressed, it saves about 30%, but I want uncompressed. I don't want to bother the camera processor with compressing. The other thing is bit depth. Do I want maximum color depth or not? Yes. So 14 bit. You can set it to 12 bit, and they say that you don't notice or won't notice, but I have 14 bit. It is there, and so I picked it. ISO sensitivity. Basic setting for the ISO I set to 100. So the lowest I shoot at is 100 ISO. I have it set to ISO auto or auto ISO. It's on. The maximum it can shoot at is 12,800. This is very high for me, and I have to test it out the coming week if that's too high or not. Minimum shutter speed I'm comfortable with is 125 or 125th. I understand you can shoot lower, but again, I have to test it out. So the lowest it will set the shutter speed to 125th. The lowest is ISO 100 and the highest is 1250, 1280. 1280, 12800. Next, white balance. You have many different settings for this, but I shoot RAW, so it doesn't really matter. And I have set it at auto 1. But even this one, if you can edit. If you put the switch to the right, you can basically mess around with colors. And I never do that. I only do that in post-processing. You also have these ones, and same thing. You can change them, but I don't. Set picture control. You can set them at auto, standard, or neutral. Because I do post-processing on pretty much everything, I set it to neutral. If you put the toggle switch to the right, you can change the picture control. Next, set picture control. I do a lot of post-processing. I don't want these created things. I don't even want to test them out. And I set them to neutral. Neutral, you can change. So your default for what is neutral on your camera can change from what's neutral on my camera for photography. So I can change this, but I won't. So neutral is fine. Do I want to save these? No. Color space. Adobe RGB has a wider color space, but I don't use it. I shoot sRGB. For now, that's the thing that I use the most. Active delighting. Nope. Long exposures. I don't do long exposures. That's a bit difficult with flying birds. High ISO number is off. Vignette control is off. Diffraction compensation is off because I shoot always below f10. Auto distortion control is off. Flicker reduction shooting is on. If you shoot indoors and you have flickering in the light, this should fix it. So I set it to on. Metering. I always set this to matrix metering. This is for matrix metering. Highlights I sometimes use, and spot metering. But for photography for now, it's matrix metering. Flash mode, I don't touch that. Focus mode. For moving subjects, I always use AFC. For stationary objects, I use single. But continuous autofocus, I use for, well, most of the time actually. Manual focus, I don't use on this camera. I use it on my D850. Area AF, single point, because I shoot single subjects, like one bird, one model, so I use single point. Vibration reduction, this is now an option because I have a Nikon lens on it that has no VR on it, so I can set it to normal, sport or off. If you have a lens that does have VR or a Tamron lens, this is grayed out. So for now, I want vibration reduction on my lens that does not have vibration reduction. So normal. Auto bracketing, leave it as this. Multiple exposures, nope. Interval shooting, nope, that's a different video. Focus shift shooting, nope. Silent photography off. Now we go to the movie shooting menu. This is the way I've set it up. Again, reset movie menu, file naming, exactly the same. You can change this if you want. Choose image area, full frame. If you have DX lenses, you can use DX mode, but I use full frame lenses. Standard, I shoot 4K in 24p. For talking heads, I use 4K. For B-roll that I haven't used yet, I use 1920 by 1080. But I use this one, 120p, because in this mode it does record sound. So you have this one for talking head, and this one for B-roll. You also have this one. It does slow motion in camera, but it does not record sound. So let's put it that way. movie file type. You have MP4 for quick sharing, or you have MOV, and I use MOV. ISO sensitivity settings, same thing. The maximum I want to use for photography or for videography is 12,800. I want it on, and I want this at 100. White balance, same as photo settings. And the reason is that when I do, let's say, a bit of photography and I do a short video and I use them in the same video for YouTube, I want to have, well, basically the same white balance, so I don't want to bother with too much editing in post-processing. Picture control, it's the same thing, same as photo settings. Manage picture control, we all went through that. Active delighting, that should be turned off. High ISO number is off. Maybe set it to normal. It's normal. Diffraction is on. Auto distortion control is on. Flicker reduction is set to auto. So if you do a recording indoors in Europe or America, I think in the US they have 60 Hertz. In Europe they have 50 Hertz. So I put it at auto. For metering, again, I use matrix. But this can change to center weight. But for now I set it to matrix. Focus mode. For video is full-time autofocus. Area AF mode is full, so the entire width of the sensor. Vibration reduction is normal, well, same as video photography. Electronic VR is off. Microphone sensitivity is 12. Annotator is off. You can set this to auto, like you can see now, it's doing pretty well, and I'm behind the camera, so it's okay. Auto manual, I've set it to manual 12, done. This one is off. Frequency response, if I do a videography of birds and the bird is singing, I would like to record that. So the widest range, this is just the vocal range. Wind noise reduction, no, I do that in post-processing. Headphone, I don't care, I don't use that. Time code, yeah, I don't use that. Custom settings menu, reset custom settings. Autofocus, A. AFC priority on release. AFS, focus. Focus tracking, if you are following a subject and it walks behind a tree, do you want to lose focus and focus on something new or not? Well, no. So you can say it should be delayed or immediately move to a different subject, but I say no. Auto AF, auto area AF. This one is from an update earlier this year. Off, face detection or face and eye detection. Well, I want face and eye detection. Focus point used. I want to use all the focus points. Store points by orientation. If you switch your camera from landscape to portrait mode, it remembers where your focus point was the last time. Do you want that on or off? For my use case, I want this on. So, yes, on. AF activation. On the Z6, I have this to just the shutter button. On my D850, I have back button focusing. So for this one, it's shutter AF only. limit AF mode selection. So these are in your iMenu all the options you have. If you do not want to have one of the options, you can basically detick them and then it's no longer a quick option. But I don't want that. Focus point wraparound. If your focus point is on the left side of your screen and you want to move very quickly to the right side of the screen, you can just push the button left and then it appears on the right side of your screen. So that's very useful. So wrap or not wrap? Wrap. Focus point options. Manual focus mode or this one? I have manual focus point mode is on. Oh, dynamic area AF assist. I have it to on. Low light. If you shoot a lot in low light, it will take more time if you turn this on to focus, but it will focus. If you turn this off, it will quickly focus and sometimes you will miss focus. So I don't shoot in low light. So for me, it's off. EF steps for exposure is a third. Basically, you leave this as it is. The fine tune you can use for when you have a very old lens and you want to tune that one, but I don't do that. C, shutter release button AAL. I have not configured it right now, so I don't. Self timer. Referring to a other video I made, if you want to take selfies, you set this. You push the button, it will start counting down like 10 seconds or let's say 5 seconds. Or you want to take a landscape picture, you just set this. Push the button and it will take pictures of yourself or wherever. Here I've set, let's say 3, 1. So I push the button, it will take 5 seconds. Then it will take 3 shots, each with an interval of 1 second. So, done. Power off delay. This is frustrating. This is the amount of time it will take before it will turn off. Image review. Yeah, like that. CL mode shooting. How many frames do you want to shoot in continuous? 5. Maximum. This is an interesting thing. If you put your camera in a bag and let's say something pushes against the button and it will turn on and it will still be pushing on that button and it will take pictures. 200 pictures before it will stop. That might mean that your camera, your memory card will be full. So maybe put this, I don't know, and it looks nice. Sync release mode options, we don't use that. Exposure delay, off. Shutter type, auto. Limit selectable image area. This is the selection you can pick. And I said standard is it's in FX. And maybe I would like to take just one picture quickly of 1.1 or 16.9, so I'll just leave it as it is. File number, leave it as it is. Apply settings to live view. This is important. If you change settings on the camera and you shoot in live view, you want to have that reflect on live view. So on live view, you can see the image as it is going to be taken. If you turn it off, you won't see that. Framing grid, I have that off. Nah, off. Peaking highlights, this is interesting. If you shoot outdoors, do you want to see the bits that are overexposed? Standard. And what kind of color would you like to see? White, yellow. If I put it red, red is for my other camera, the in-focus bits. Just put it blue. View all in continuous mode. Yep, on. Flash sync speed. If you shoot at high speed sync, put it in here. So I put it, just put it in there. It's not important. Not important, not important. If you, this for the video side, if you want to set up a specific, oh, let's go back. If you want to set up a specific eye menu for photography, is for the photo side, you can set it up here. If you want to do this for videography, you can do it here. So you have your eye menu for both video or photography. Custom control assignments, no, OK button. AF speed, this is important. If you are doing photography of talking heads, so you want to quickly focus when something changes, you use this one. So I have set it to faster. AF tracking sensitivity. How sensitive is it? High. So if I move backwards, it sees it immediately and focuses very fast on where I am. If you this one, the spanner setup menu, you always format your card. Save user settings, language. If you speak, well, that's Greek to me. Then you can set it there. Time zone and date. You set it here. It's already set. Monitor brightness. AF fine tune again. And this you don't use actually. This one is the retouch menu, and basically I just never use it because I shoot in RAW. This is a menu I already set up a bit. That's the metering for photography and for videography. And if you want, you can let's think of something. You can set it up. So what you have now is file name, metering, and metering. That's how I. So and now it's gone again. So this is pretty much how I set it up. If you have any questions regarding the menu or a function, or want to know what delighting is, or anything of the Nikon menu, please let me know, and I will make a separate video on it, or I will explain it in the comments. I will do a video on time-lapse work and that kind of stuff, so that's a separate video. Thank you for now, and yeah, that's it. Please subscribe. Yeah, please subscribe and like, so people can find my video. Thank you, bye-bye.